what you count on, and I like what you just said. First corner, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, and go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Now the gun down on third down.
Thanks for our visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd and felt they had to hide their valuable when they were out of town.
Well, the home crowd quiet down early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. And this will be down just on the other side of midfield. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down for him.
Well, it doesn't take any great analysis. No jokes, partner.
Okay, all right, on this one.
But we just know that we're going to see this as the game moves forward. There's going to be two guys on him on just about every snap.
It's kind of a dare to throw his way, but they have to keep throwing it. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. A man who has done this a lot, Justin Houston, in there to record the sack.
Nice pass rush there by Justin. Absolutely rejuvenating. Plus, he changed positions from outside linebacker to defensive end and had his first double-digit sack season since 2014.
And that one incomplete. He had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings that fourth down. Michael, now here's Michael Dixon. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. He's brought down at the 34, call it a gain of four.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage and mixed traffic. But in this case, I'm on the free safety. Coming up and making the big-time play.
Second and six. Flushed out right. And now he's going to use his legs. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch 22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on?
Up to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Catch and run there, good for 16, the first.
And what a nice example there of a tight end doing exactly what he needs to do. How about how he worked his way to the outside, made sure he secured the catch, and then anything after that, we count that as a bonus, and indeed, he gets enough for the first down.
He's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Midfield and inside the 35. That one covers 29 yards.
50-50 ball, right? We always talk about that. Both sides had a chance to get it, the receiver or the guy covering him. But I think the odds actually are in favor of the offense. They can see the ball coming oftentimes before the defender can get his head around. So I think that really goes to like 70-30, and they should be able to go up and get it most of the time.
And he got it there. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. That's over another. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 19 yards there on the catch and run.
And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there. And he did a lot of that on that play.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Yeah, he was able to shed one tackle, but could not get away from there. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And the Jaguars are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
Well, no doubt, home run here in the backfield now can take him the distance. But a short yardage, trying to pick up first downs. That big guy. Oh, it's a nice luxury to have, isn't it? Second, I thought that might there was an opening, still ended up with a solid game.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Justin Houston at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over.
Take it down.
emotions are running high, intentions are the same. Who can control them best could ultimately win it.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. So first and 10 now from the 30. Back to throw. Escaping the pressure right. It's caught on the right side by Robinson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 17 now. Here's a first and 10. And I would expect pressure here. He takes it back in the